I'm stable. Oh yeah, you're playable. Oh yeah, you know me. I have only a path. I'm lonely, but damn, I'm going to win. Yeah. I'm the one of the elders in the community, a little bit older. So I've had, first of all, I've just had a really blessed life. Man, I count my blessings every day. Just, you know, no matter what goes on, it's always a big blessing for me. And I'm just really grateful. I was raised in a single parent. I'm a mom and I had a brother and sister. Real strong mom, just her and us three kids growing up. Set some good, you know, instilled in us some good stuff of, you know, always treating people correct, with respect and, you know, go out, work ethic, just everything, really strong lady. So I was really lucky to have, you know, her as a mom and grow up in a close knit family, you know, not having a father figure, but she could act as both. So it worked out really well. Grew up in the, my mom had, is in the fitness industry for 36 years. So I was kind of born in the gym, as a little kid and in the nursery and just grew up. And when I was in high school, I had a neck injury in football. And so, I had a big brother that played football. He was paid college and pro. He was a big guy, a lot bigger than me. And I hurt my neck. And so I couldn't do contact sports. So I started working out in the garage with my brother, and I wanted to do it because he was so much bigger and his friends always picked on me, but I wanted to get big so I could whip him, but I could get his friends, but I never could whip my brother. So, but with that being said, we opened up a family fitness center right out of high school. I did a little bit of college, but I wasn't very good with school. I was just all over the place. My mom opened a gym for us and down in Clear Lake City, down by Galveston in the, you know, Houston, South Houston down there. My mom opened a gym for us, and I did that, and I got into bodybuilding. I just liked it. I didn't like it at first because I thought it was a lot of cheesy, but once I got into it and I did really well with it, then I kind of got hooked on it. And part of the bodybuilding was one of my best buddies, Lee Labrada. He has Labrada Nutrition. He's in Houston. And he was a pro and very, very good, a pro bodybuilder. So as I competed, I got to travel with him all over Europe, France, Spain, Italy, England. And he would do a tour and I would go with him and we'd go like town to town and meet everybody. And it was... The thing about I liked about bodybuilding was it taught me a lot of discipline, one. And then two, I got out and I got to meet a lot of people, got lots of friends from all over, and just really, you know, I learned a lot, and it was the stepping stone to where I met Bill Phillips. Bill Phillips had an experimental applied science out in Golden, Colorado, and he's the author of Body for Life, which is a really popular book, the number one bestseller for a long time. And we had these, he had these Body for Life contests where people would, you know, do a before and after. And that was real big. And, but the reason why I mentioned working with Bill was it was back right before 93 to 98, was right before the internet. And he was an old school copywriter. And he used to have Dan Kennedy and Gary Halbert out for a weekend and he would pay them. And he would get these ideas from him, like just 8 hours Saturday and Sunday, and just take all these little notes. And then after that, he would come up with these big campaigns. And back then it was direct response. Like it was in the mail or USA Today. We had a magazine called Muscle Media. We had a magazine as a platform. We had the mailing database of just thousands of people. And it was fitness, you know, bodybuilding, but people just wanting to get in shape and change what they were doing. And so when I was doing that, I got a little bits of pieces because Dan Kennedy and those guys are really, I read his book back then. It was really amazing because of how well they did with just writing copy. Mm-hmm. And Bill was really, really good at it. And I would study his, and I got a little piece of it. Then when I left there, I went to, from Colorado, I went back to Dallas, and I decided, hey, why not give real estate a shot? Because I had sold in a house. I bought a house and sold it in Colorado. And I, during the process, I thought, it's pretty cool. You know, I like, you can get relationships, you know, it was real estate. So moved to Dallas, jumped in the real estate. The first day that I got my license, I went to a seminar out in San Diego and got with this group where I could kind of copy and paste to help they get your business going. So went out there, jumped in that, came back, set up my systems, and just took off and didn't know anybody in Dallas. my first year, I was just out and I was meeting people and just started selling houses, man. And I got hooked on that and did that for 8 years in the Dallas area. You know, I've been here for 19 years, did that for 8 years. And then 2008, when the market went down, I again went back to work for Bill Phillips 10 years later. And we had an online community called Transformation. It was transforming body, mind, and spirit. We would meet at half marathons around, and we would donate all our proceeds to Make-A-Wish Foundation. So we work with them. We would go do the half marathons, and then we had a huge community, transformation.com. And just I was a coach, and I got to coach a lot of people, meet a lot of people. And when that went away, all the people now are still on Facebook, so I get to see all of them from 10 years back. And so and after that, I went over and I started selling on Amazon. First, I started at eBay for a year, and then I advanced up to Amazon, which was like night and day from selling on eBay to selling on Amazon. I jumped into that, and I did that for 3 years. And then one day, I woke up, and my account was suspended because of selling policies they changed. And it's very hard to get your account reinstated over there. And so I just like, I've got to find something, man. I got to do something because a lot of income went away overnight, you know? And so we had our savings and we went from no debt to maxed out and savings, because my wife has a great job, but man, you know, used to what we were spending, it was kind of, we had to cut back. And so anyway, I'm not really looking, but I got my kind of antenna up, and I'm on YouTube one day, and I figured out when Kiala popped up, it was because he was running a little ad on YouTube. You know, he pops up in the video, and I was about to X out of it. And I thought, man, this dude's pretty cool. I like what he's saying. He's walking through his house, a little mesmerizing, you know, he's talking to you. He kind of gets you caught up in it. And after eight minutes and 30 seconds, I just said, I'm into this. I jumped on it. I didn't even do the webinar. I just jumped on it, went in, did the coaching call, got set up. That was last November. And got set up, didn't do much studying in November, December, but jumped in it in January. So started really studying in January, and February 15th, I started promoting on Facebook. My first ad, I had 33 sales in about 3 weeks. And then I got my account disabled, because I kind of knew what I was doing, but I really didn't know what I was doing. You know, Devin Thomas, who you had on, he was kind of mentoring me, and so I took off with it really well. I did, from that one ad, I did 10,200, 33 sales from the back end sales as well. And then I got back on it. I started again, and you know, I've had 52 or 53 sales, and I've been well, but I took off really well. I've just had a hard time going back and forth with my account, but you know, that's just the way it is. And so now I'm 7-8 months in the business. I have my YouTube, I have my Instagram, I have Facebook, just doing a lot of different things within, you know, AWOL, my affiliate, just learning, man. There's like unlimited learning all the time, each day. I try to help a lot of people because it helps me with learning my, you know, chakras, my tool. But so now that takes me to AWOL. And so here I am today.